Hey friends, did you know that you can now parameterize the connections to your data stores in Azure Data Factory? Makes it much easier when working with multiple data stores and to manage all those connections. Gaurav Malhotra is here to show us how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott Hanselman. This is another episode of Azure Friday. We've been talking about the Azure Data Factory, and I was complimenting you and your team about the speed at which you were making improvements. You're really doing everything you can to smooth things out, whether it be something small that adds up and changes someone's workflow fundamentally. Yes. And now you're adding a parameterized connections for data storage. And how's that going to make my life easier?
So we have heard feedback from our customers, right, where they are, let's say, connecting to 10 SQL servers, right, on-prem SQL Server or SQL Azure, SQL Cloud Database. And the only thing that's different between those 10 SQL servers is the server name, because for the consistency reasons, they are keeping the same username and password. So as before this release, they had to create 10 separate connections to 10 separate SQL servers in Data Factory. But now what we are saying is that you can create a single link service and parameterize that server name. So that now from a manageability aspect, you are just managing one link service in your Data Factory rather than 10 separate ones. And also, if you are an ISV or a systems integrator who is coding using our REST APIs or using our partial commandlets or using our ARM templates approach to create your pipelines, you would just have one link service with a parameterized server name in there, and at runtime you can provide values to that.
Interesting. It seems like there's a theme here, because in another episode of Azure Friday that folks can check out, you talked about how the integration runtime would ordinarily have to have one for each. And now it's kind of normalized.
Yes.
You know, you're doing some normalization across, looking for places where things are unnecessarily duplicated.
Yes. So we, our goal is, as a team, is to improve productivity for our customers, right? And we are, as you would see in our different releases, we are very closely watching customer feedback. And based on that, seeing how we can make them more productive and make things usable for them. So this is another example where we have listened to customer feedback and we have released this new feature where you can now parameterize your link services in Data Factory.
Can you show me what that looks like?
Yes. So if I go to, again, this is Azure portal. I have a demo factory created in it. If I click author and monitor, it takes me to this visual tools that we have for Data Factory.
Okay.
If I go in the author tab over here, I have this resource explorer where I can see all my pipelines. And I have this connections tab. So if I click this connections tab, it opens up this, and you can see that I have a bunch of connections already created over here. So if I click edit for a particular connection, and in this particular case, you can see that now we allow you to parameterize. And the way to know it is, as you hover, you can see that this add dynamic content is coming.
So all those places where someone potentially could have hard-coded something.
Yes. So you can see that it is coming for your server name, for database name. So let's click on the one for database name, right? So it takes you to this site panel where now you can parameterize your database name for this particular SQL server. So you can use the rich expression language that we have for Data Factory. Now in this case, again, usability is the key for our customers that we are trying to enable. And you can see that if you pasted this, it is telling you it's invalid because I still haven't created a DB name parameter. But I can do it right from here instead of going back and creating that parameter and coming back here. If I click plus new here and I say DB name and it is of type string. And I don't want to give any default value, so if I click save, if I wanted to give a default value,
you could kind of hard code without hard coding.
Yes.
Give it a default value and then override it if you need
to. So it has created this parameter, and now you can see that it's all valid. I'm not getting that error message, and I can say finish. And not only this, you can use, you can, like I said, you could parameterize, as you can see, your server name in a similar fashion as well. So totally up to you what you want to do and parameterize. And all these values would be passed at runtime now, right? So if you had 10 SQL servers and at runtime, let's say you're maintaining a file and you could go look up against those, look up against that file to get the list of those, and you can pass it to this link service.
So help me understand the scoping though. When we create a variable, and I'm putting variables in air quotes like this, is it scoped at the pipeline level? Is it scoped at the like anywhere within my entire factory, mm-hmm. or is it, you know, how does it work? Do I have to think about scoping?
Yes, so this particular parameter is scoped at your pipeline level, okay. right? And there are different scopes that we enable. You create parameters at data set level as well, and you can pass values to those parameters from your pipeline to data set and then to your link service, right?
Okay.
So there are different scopes that we enable, and there is a mechanism by which you can pass parameters across these different scopes.
I see, okay.
Yeah, so this is all available today for customers to use. We have our documentation published on how you can get started with this and start to use that using our visual tools and Parameterize. We have the JSON. If you want to use the JSON approach and do it using that, you can do it using JSON as well.
Do you have a particular tip or a strategy for someone who might have recognized this as a problem and they've got a bunch of copies of data sources? Should they simply delete them all en masse and then add one and then go back and add them manually, or should they use the JSON technique?
So I would say they should just go use our programmatic interface to go delete all of those and then parameterize the link service and use that. Because from a manageability aspect, or in future, if let's say a username password change, or if you have a new server that gets added into the mix, instead of adding a new link service, all you need to say at runtime, pass this additional value because I have one new server to cater to.
Got it. Very cool. So it's available now, and people are just going to get it the next time they log in and
cache
and when they see the new portal.
Yes.
Fantastic. Absolutely. All right. Lots of great improvements in the Azure Data Factory. And if you just saw this one video, I would encourage you to check out all of our other great videos, not just on Azure Friday, because we're at over 500 videos now, but also our great Azure Data Factory videos. See you soon.